our morning scripture this morning. The Lord bless each and every one of you. It's a beautiful week of blessings. It's a week of the fullness of the blessings of the Lord. That's what I heard the Lord impress on my heart for this week. Every one of you, you're going to receive the fullness of the blessings of God. And when we talk about the fullness, I'm talking about the increase of His government in your life. I'm talking about the kingdom of God being made manifest in your ministry, in your houses of prayer. The fullness of God in your health. You're going to be totally healed this week. Wherever you were experiencing pains in your body, I sense a healing anointing for this week. You're going to experience the fullness of God in your finances. The Lord is going to provide for you according to His riches and glory. This is that kind of week. This is a week to experience the fullness of the blessings of God. The fullness, the fullness, the fullness of God. His full measure of blessings has come. And this morning I want you to begin to tap into the fullness of it. I want you to gain a perspective for the full measure, the full measure. It's a full measure. I want you to understand when God sends a blessing, the blessing is released in the fullness of who Yeshua is. And so I've got a morning devotion scripture for you. But I want you to gain a perspective this morning for the fullness. The full measure of healing is coming. The full measure of increase on your prayer life is coming. The full measure of worship and adoration unto Yeshua is coming. The full measure for biblical truth from the Holy Scriptures, it's coming. Beloved, all of this is part of the fullness of the measure of God's blessing. Many times, what I have realized is that a lot of people, they are satisfied with 50% of the blessing. People are satisfied with 70% of the blessing. But there is a place in the spirit that you and I can go to receive the fullness of His blessing, the fullness of His mercies, the fullness of His grace. There is a place, there is a place, there is a place in the spirit that you can go to receive the fullness of what Christ has for you. And that's what we want, the fullness this morning. This is that week. This is the week where many of you, you're stepping over from 75% to 100%. We're moving into the full measure of God's blessings and God's promises. We're moving into the fullness of healing. I want you to receive that this morning. I want you to receive it with your spirit and not with your intellect. This is a word of the spirit. This is not a word for intellectual interpretation. Receive it in your spirit. The full measure is coming. The fullness of His blessings. I'm going to read the prayer that I have been praying over you. And this is such a beautiful prayer. This is a prayer that Apostle Paul prayed for the churches of his time. Apostle Paul prayed this powerful prayer for the Corinthian church. He prayed for the church in Ephesus, the Ephesian church. Apostle Paul labored intensively for the growth and development of the churches of his time. And he prayed this prayer so that the people of his time may receive the fullness of the blessing. And this is the prayer that I have been praying for you this morning. So as I sit in my prayer room here, I'm going to pray this prayer over you. And I want you to receive this prayer. And then I want you to take this prayer and run with this prayer. Pray this prayer over your homes. Pray this prayer over your families. Pray this prayer over your houses of prayer, over people that you are interceding for. I want you to pray this prayer. This is the prayer that is going to bring you into the fullness of the blessings and the full measure of what God has for you. We are not settling for 75%. And we're not settling for 80 or 85. We want 100%, the full measure of blessing. Ephesians chapter 1. I will read from verse 15. I'm just going to read from verse 15 to verse 18. When you are saying this prayer, you can read out the entire chapter from verse 15. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 15 to verse 18. This is a prayer that Apostle Paul prayed. Wherefore, I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love unto all the saints, I have ceased not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom, that he may give you the spirit of revelation in the knowledge of him, that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of the inheritance in the saints is. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Father, I thank you for this powerful prayer this morning that the apostle prayed for the church of Ephesus. This morning, I'm praying this prayer over all my friends and partners this morning. This is a prayer, mighty God, that will open our understanding to who you are and what you have called us to be. This is a prayer, mighty God, that the apostle prayed to open the understanding of the church of Ephesus, that they may receive the fullness of your love, that they may have received the full measure of wisdom, that they may receive the full measure of revelation through the knowledge of Yeshua. And this is the prayer that I pray this morning for all my friends and partners, for every intercessor connected, for every gatekeeper connected. I pray this prayer this morning. Father, in the mighty name of Yeshua, I have ceased not to give thanks for them, that the God of our Lord Jesus, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom, that he may give unto you the spirit of revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua, that the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened to know what the hope of your calling is. Oh Father, this morning, hear the prayers of your people. We are praying Ephesians chapter 1 from verse 15 to verse 18 over the saints. Father, hear the prayers, oh God. Hear our prayer this morning. We are praying. Understanding to be enlightened, Lord. Father, open the eyes of my understanding that it will be enlightened to understand the mysteries of your kingdom in this last day, to understand how far I should go, when I should go, when I should stand up, when I should hide, when I should push forward. Lord, open the eyes of my understanding. Open the eyes of my understanding. Lord, open the eyes of my understanding. Let my eyes be enlightened with the mysteries of your kingdom. Let my eyes be enlightened with the mysterious glories of your kingdom. We are praying Ephesians chapter 1 from verse 15 to 18, and you can pray the entire chapter because the entire chapter is a prayer from verse 15. So Father, I pray, Lord, that you open our eyes. Help us to understand what is going on. going on in the Middle East. Open the eyes of our understanding that we will understand what's happening with the peace treaty in the Middle East. Open our eyes so that we can understand, and give us a heart to pray for Israel. Give us a love to pray for Jerusalem. Give us a heart to love the Jewish people. Give us a heart to understand what is happening in the Middle East, the wars, the war that is ensuing on the Temple Mount. Give us a heart to understand, Lord. For Father, the days are gone when we can say, well, we don't know what's happening. Because now all you have to do is pray the right prayer and turn on the right channels, and you can get the knowledge that you need so that we can pray an effective prayer. Father, so many people are saying that they are intercessors, but their eyes are dim to what is happening in the world. There is no intercession going on for the nations of the world. All we can see is us. All we can see is our own family, our own nation. Our eyes need to be opened, Lord. And so this morning, Lord, open the eyes of every intercessor that is here. Open the eyes of every gatekeeper that is here. Every prayer warrior that is here. Lord, open our eyes. Open the eyes of our understanding that you will give us the knowledge. You will give us the knowledge of how we should pray in these last days. Open our eyes. Open the eyes of intercessors, watchmen, prophets. Open our eyes, Lord. We need to see so that we can be able to effectively watch and pray. If we are watching and praying, then we have to have eyes to see what we are praying for and what we are praying against. Open our eyes to see. Open our eyes, Lord, that our prayer will not be in vain, that our prayer will not be repetitive, that our prayer will not be a selfish prayer, that our prayer will miss. We don't want our prayer to miss, but we want to be sharp in the spirit. We need to be marksmen in the spirit. To be a marksman in the spirit, we got to be able to see. We got to be able to see deep in the realms of the spirit to be an effective marksman. Father, this morning I'm praying that you open the eyes of the intercessors. Open the eyes of gatekeepers of families. Open the eyes of prayer warriors and prophets, God, prayer leaders, God. Father, open our eyes that we can see and discern where the enemy is coming in from, so that we can be sharp shooters in the realms of the spirit. Open our eyes to see that our prayer will be effective, Lord. This is my prayer this morning. Father, so many families are being targeted. They're being targeted, and the enemy is shooting down families because of blindsidedness. But this morning, I'm praying that you remove scales, remove the blinders, remove the scales, open our eyes to see. Let the scales be removed, let the blindness be removed, let the deafness and the dullness of the spirit be removed. Open their eyes to see in the realms of the spirit. God, give them the passion to pray once again. Give your people the passion to pray and to intercede with accuracy, not rhetorical prayers, not mundane prayers, not rehearsed prayers, prayers from a book. No, we'll not work in this hour. Give us the spirit of accuracy to pray, God. Accuracy, 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 accuracy in the realms of the spirit. Lord, I'm asking you this morning, give us accuracy, every intercessor under the sound of my voice. We need accuracy in the realms of the spirit. Father, when you called Moses to build the tabernacle in the wilderness, you gave Moses an accurate blueprint how to build that tabernacle, because you are an accurate God. You are an accurate God. You gave Moses specific instructions how to build the tabernacle, line upon line, precept upon precept, measurement upon measurement, cubit upon cubit. You gave Moses accurate instructions. And so, Father, you are not a God that misses. And that you are not raising up an army of people that will miss in the spirit. The people that are missing are the people that are not yielding, God. We got to yield to the spirit so that we will not miss in the spirit. We got to yield to the spirit so that we will hear the Father calling us up to the high places. We got to yield our spirit. And to yield our spirit, it means to kill the flesh. God, give your people the power this morning to kill the flesh, to kill the desires and the appetite of the flesh. Give us the power to kill the flesh. The flesh got to move out of the way in order for the spirit to live. The flesh has got to die so the spirit can rise. The flesh has got to die so the spirit man can be elevated. Father, you are an accurate God and you have accurate blueprints. You've got accurate blueprints. You've got accurate blueprints. Accurate blueprints. You've got accurate directions for the people of God in this hour and in this season. And so, Father, it is up to us to interpret correctly. So this morning, my prayer is that you will open the eyes of our understanding and let it be enlightened so that we can accurately interpret the blueprints. Help us to accurately interpret, Lord. Give us the mind to be able to accurately interpret the strategy of this hour. There is a plan of action for this hour. Give us the mind of the Spirit so that we can accurately interpret what you are saying. For God, you are talking. God, you are talking to the praying church. You're calling and you're talking to the praying people. I pray that the eyes of their understanding be open and that their ears be open to hear, that we will not miss. Father, so many people are going around the mountain over and over and over and over, doing the same thing, expecting a different result. Father, let that never be us, Lord. We want to have the divine strategy. And we want to be able to follow the divine plan of action. Father, give us eyes to see in the realms of the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of revelation. We want the spirit of revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua. Father, give us the spirit of revelation. The spirit of revelation is such a key spirit for these last days. We need the spirit of revelation, but just not just any spirit of revelation. We need the spirit of revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua. That's what the apostle prayed in this prayer. Ephesians 1 and chapter 1 verse 17. Ephesians 1 verse 17. Apostle Paul was praying that the God of our Lord Jesus, the Father of glory, will give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. The spirit of wisdom. When the spirit of wisdom comes, the spirit of wisdom leads us, guides us, preserves us. The spirit of wisdom is a preserving agent for the saints. The spirit of wisdom is a preserving power for the saints. The spirit of wisdom preserves us in the work. The spirit of wisdom preserves us in our advancement. The spirit of wisdom tells us when to wait and when to push forward. The spirit of wisdom, it is the preserving power of God unto the saints. The spirit of wisdom tells us when to shoot and when to hold back our firepower. The spirit of wisdom. And so, Father, I pray that you will give us the spirit of wisdom, Lord. Give us the spirit of wisdom. Sataka rabaka sataka yata. Rabaka sataka yanda rabaka sataka. Give us the spirit of wisdom, Lord. For wisdom is the principal thing. In all thy getting, give us wisdom, Lord. Give us wisdom, Lord, and understanding to understand our family members, to understand prayer partners, to understand the people that you have called us to work with and to labor with. Give us the spirit of wisdom, Lord, and revelation in the knowledge of Him. Father, so many people, Lord, so many people are tied up in man-made revelations, Lord. Fleshly revelations, Lord. The revelations of man will never work in this final hour, Lord. The revelation of man's intellect will never work, Lord. It's the revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua. So many people are going into the dream world and bringing back false revelations, Lord. Have mercy, Lord. So many people are entering into the dream world and coming back with devilish revelations, counterfeit revelations. My God, Lord, have mercy. I don't know who the Spirit of the Lord is talking to, but God is saying, stop going into the dream world and coming back with false revelations. Those revelations are devilish. It's fleshly and it is not of God. The Bible says, ask for the revelations of Yeshua. Ask for the revelations of the knowledge of Yeshua. Lord, I pray that you would give your people the revelations of the knowledge of Yeshua. Father, I pray that those who have been going into the dream world and coming back with false revelations, that they would stop. I pray that those who have been going into the dream world and bringing back wrong revelations, leading others astray with wrong, fleshly, devilish revelations, I pray that they would stop. The Lord says, stop. Stop. And ask for the knowledge. Ask for the knowledge, the revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua. That's the revelation that will help us in this hour and in this season. Father, I pray for the saints of God this morning. Give them the revelation in the knowledge of Yeshua. Wherever the enemy have taken their dream life under siege, God, I break it in the realms of the spirit. Wherever the devil have taken your dream life and put it under siege, I break it in the realms of the spirit. I break the hold. I break the siege. I break it in the realms of the spirit. All sorts of wrong things the devil have been showing people in their dreams, causing them to be confused, causing them to be scattered because he knows there is a call on your life. Wherever the devil have taken your dream life under siege, I break it in the realms of the spirit. I break it in the realms of the spirit. I break it in the realms of the spirit. I send the Holy Ghost and fire ahead to unlock your dream life, to unlock your dreams, to unlock your mind so that you can begin to receive the Spirit of God in your dreams. You can begin to see and understand the mysteries of the kingdom in your dreams. You can begin to have end time revelations concerning cities and villages and nations in your dream. I break the powers of darkness holding dream lives. I break the powers of darkness bringing the minds of God people under siege in their dreams. I break it, I break it, I break it, I break it, I break it this morning in the realms of the spirit. Your life will be loosed and liberated this week. Because the Spirit of the Lord is here, I'm hearing the Lord say, this week you will have such a divine encounter with the Lord. No more mad dreams, no more crazy dreams, no more crazy things. You're going to have a meaningful revelation that can advance the church. A meaningful revelation. Father, let's pray that prayer this morning. The angels are here and they are picking up prayer requests. Let's ask the Lord for a meaningful revelation that can advance the church in our dreams. Father, this morning we are praying for a meaningful revelation that can advance the church in the knowledge of Yeshua. Lord, we are praying for a meaningful revelation that can advance the church in the knowledge of Yeshua. That's our prayer this morning for our dream world. No more squatters in the dream world. No more squatters in the dream world. No more crazy demonic squatters. No more flying witches in the dream world. No more, no more. No more going down into the sea in the dream world. No more. No more squatters. We give the squatters an eviction notice this morning. No more thriller dreams. No more horror dreams. No more nightmare dreams. The power of Yeshua breaks it this morning. The power of Adonai breaks it this morning. No more horror dreams. The blood of Yeshua just begins to cleanse. Cleanse. The film strip of your dreams is being cleansed. The blood of Yeshua cleanses the film strip. The film strip of your dreams is being cleansed right now. No more mystical dreams. Father, give us a meaningful dream revelation that can advance the church through the knowledge of the ecclesia. Sata kayanda rabaka sata. A meaningful revelation. We want meaningful revelations now. We want meaningful revelations to advance the body of Christ. We want meaningful revelations. So many people get tied up in their dreams, believing what they dream, and believing in all sorts of false revelations, except what the Word of God says. We have to begin to be guided by biblical truth and biblical revelation. And so, Lord, we are asking for meaningful revelations. Meaningful revelations. Meaningful revelations in the knowledge of Yeshua. No more wasting time trying to figure out wrong dreams. No more wasting time. No more wasting time. We've got to advance the kingdom of God in the earth. We've got places to go, people to meet, crusades to host, baptisms to do, counseling sessions to do. We've got things to do for the Lord. No more wasting time. Meaningful revelations. And so, Father, that's our prayer this morning. That's our prayer. This morning, Lord, as we are advancing in this week, I speak the blessings of the Lord upon every person here. I speak the blessings of the Lord upon your home life, upon your prayer life, the blessings of the Lord upon your time of meditation in the Holy Scriptures. The blessing of the Lord will increase the Word of God in your life. And so I pray that prayer this morning. Father, increase our word life. Increase our word life. Cause us to be filled with the Word of God. Every square inch of our bodies, let it be filled with the Word and the Holy Scriptures, that the enemy will never be able to find any part of us. When he looks at us, he will see Yeshua all over. All over will be the written Word of God, and the Spirit of Yeshua will be inside of us. And so I speak that blessing over your life. I decree and declare over your week, you will have need of nothing. You will have need of nothing. The Lord will bless you this week real good. Favor will come and meet favor. Blessings will come to meet blessings. Increase will come to meet increase. You will have money to pay your bills. You will pay your bills on time. Monies that have been locked up will be loosed into your hands. The Lord will give you budgeting power, budgeting power, budgeting power. No more. You're not going to squander anything, but you're going to advance the kingdom of God in the earth with the resources that God has given to you. You will stop wishing and wishing that you had more and you had this and you had whatever, making excuse. But whatever little the Lord gives you, you are going to budget it. Whatever little the Lord gives you, you will budget it rightfully. You will budget it well. You will do what you are supposed to do. You will bless the Lord's house. You will give your tithes and your offerings, and you will make it work. You will make it work. Because only when you are faithful in the little can God bless you with greater. No more excuses. No more excuses. No more excuses. Father, in the name of Jesus, as you bless the people of God, give them wisdom for money management. As you bless the saints, give them wisdom for money management. Remove the spirit of complaining. Remove the spirit of complaining. Too many complainers. Remove that spirit. Father, give your people money management and give them satisfaction, that they will be satisfied. Father, help your people to be satisfied with what they have been given. Father, we have a roof over our head. That's so much. That's more than enough to give thanks for. Give your people satisfaction. Divine satisfaction comes upon you this week. Divine satisfaction. No more complaining. No more quarreling. No more wanting to buy things that you cannot afford. Remove that greedy spirit. Divine satisfaction comes upon you this morning. Divine satisfaction. You will be satisfied. You will have money management. You will eat in your portion. You will never eat outside of your portion. You will not eat out the blessings. You will not be your own living canker worm. I remove that spirit off of you. You will not be your own living, breathing caterpillar and canker worm, eating all the blessings of the Lord. I remove that spirit. And I decree and declare you will follow the divine principles for biblical finances. We all know what the principles are. Nobody has to tell you the principles. You know very well what the divine principles are for biblical finances. Now all you need is discipline to follow it. May you receive discipline, 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 discipline for biblical management, financial management, discipline for financial management to handle the blessings of the Lord with wisdom. Too many complainers. Father, I thank you that you are giving us, all of us, discipline, that every single one of us will be able to discipline ourselves when it comes to eating, discipline ourselves when it comes to buying things, discipline ourselves when it comes to bill payments. Help us to pay the bills that are coming, and important bills. Let us pay bills on time and pay bills first before anything else, and not eat out all our blessings like human canker worms. Father, in the name of Jesus, you are giving us the fullness of your blessing. The fullness of your blessings have come. And when the fullness comes, you have to root out the parts that don't work. So God, I'm asking you, root out the parts that don't work. Root it up and out of the church. Root it up and out of the praying people. Root it up and out of our family members. Move out the parts that are not working. And give us wisdom to work the parts that are working. Give us wisdom how to advance. Give us wisdom how to go forward. Give us wisdom how to receive the fullness and how to keep the fullness of the blessings. Receiving the blessing is hardly ever the problem for some people. It's keeping the blessing. So now we are asking the Lord, give us wisdom to receive the blessing and then wisdom to keep the blessing. You've got to be able to keep the blessing in your hands. Father, give us wisdom when we receive the blessing, that we will be able to keep the blessings. It will last us. It will last us. We will not just become our own human canker worms and then eat and belch and say, yes, the Lord has been good, and there is nothing remain for next week, nothing for tomorrow, nothing to be a blessing to the house of the Lord. No, we are not doing that. Wise, wisdom, the spirit of wisdom comes this morning. The spirit of wisdom comes this morning. Father, I thank you for the fullness of the blessing. It's a week of the fullness of the blessings. Woo. It's a week of the fullness of the blessings. Oh, hallelujah. It's a week of fullness. Woo. So many of you, something broke in the realms of the spirit. I don't know what it is, but I hear the Lord say, I am bringing you the fullness of the blessing. The fullness has come. Your pocket is going to be full. Your bread basket will be full. Your worship life goes to another level. Your prayer life goes to another level. The fullness of the blessings have come this morning. Oh, Father, we thank you. the fullness of the blessing has come. And Lord, whatever area that you are blessing us in, we are grateful. We are grateful. We're so grateful. We're grateful that we have a roof over our head. We're grateful for running water. We're grateful we have a refrigerator. It has beverages in it. We're grateful for divine protection, your angelic armies encamps around us and our families. We're just so grateful. You are watching over our children. You are watching over our loved ones. Father, you are the one that brings conviction to the souls of men. And so all that we need to do is worship you, praise you, and follow your plan of action. And you're going to do the rest. We're grateful, God. We're so blessed and so grateful for all the blessings. We're blessed and we're grateful for all the blessings this morning. Lord, I seal every prayer in the precious blood of Yeshua, and I call it done. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Well, saints of God, I'm bringing us into a close right now. I want to play this beautiful song by Judy Jacobs. Hallelujah. Because I really believe that many of you, you're stepping into the fullness of the blessings of the Lord this week. And where the enemy had tried to set you up and sabotage us last week, he's not going to be able to touch your blessings this week. Your blessings are sealed in the blood. Your worship is going to be sealed in the blood. Your prayer life sealed in the blood. Your relationships sealed in the blood of Yeshua. Everything you put your hands to do this week, it shall be blessed. It shall be prosperous. It shall be fruitful. You are going to experience the blessings of the Lord in a way like never before this week. I'm telling you, I felt it. I felt a shift in the spirit this morning. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're getting ready to go this morning, saints of God. Why don't we worship our way out of the prayer? Blessings reigns on your life.